So it's midwinter, late season, if you will, and we're setting off to fish an offshore area on the mudflats of Mille Lacs. And you know, these mudflats are really interesting because there can be a lot more than meets the eye to your average mudflat. And we came out here, we used the GPS, used the contours, we got close to where we saw an irregularity on those contours, drilled a bunch of holes outside, kind of confirmed our depths, and basically set the house across the break. And I could tell that there was something not quite the same about this part of the mudflat compared to the rest of it. And then once we dropped a camera, we could really see what was going on. As you can see, there's almost an underwater ravine or a big kind of crease that runs down the edge of it. And those crags and those crevices, those irregularities are what help hold a lot more fish than most of the rest of the flat. And if you were gonna go about finding those on your average lake map, you really are looking for small little jogs, anything that deviates from normal in terms of the contour map. And the reason for that is as they collect these points, they're sending down sonar pings and sonar shots and individual points. Now, when there's a dense network of those points along an area just like this, it would map it really well, but they're also trying to cover broad areas and big acreage. So maybe there was only one point that hit just the very edge of this crease, this kind of underwater ravine. So what that's reflected in your contours is just a small little jog in it. All it is just a little nub. And that's how you go back and you look at your map and you look for areas that look very regular for a long distance along those edges of the flats. And then you see a tiny little jog in it. A lot of times what I have found is when you look at those little jogs and you drop an underwater camera, you've got something really interesting. A lot of people don't know there can be rocks on mudflats, there can be sand transitions, there can be gravel, there can be all kinds of different points, twists and turns that are really fish holding magnets. So do yourself a favor the next time you go out and you're gonna fish a mudflat, look for a small irregularity on that contour map and go ahead, drill a bunch of holes to confirm exactly where you are along the break and drop an underwater camera. You might be surprised and you might find a place that you'll end up fishing for the rest of your life because it's super interesting and it holds fish.